In this video, we will discuss about application of the equation of motion. Here we will discuss one application, that is vertical motion of a body. Let us discuss example 3.4 for the vertical motion of a body. Example 3.4, a ball is thrown vertically upwards with a velocity of 20 meter per second from the top of a multi-story building. The height of the point from where the ball is thrown is 25 meter from the ground. You have to find out how high will the ball rise. And second question, how long will it be before the ball hits the ground? You have to take the value of acceleration due to gravity, 10 meter per second square. So this is the height of the building. The height of the building is 25 meter. This is the ground surface. And this is the position of the ball. The ball is thrown upward with a velocity 20 meter per second from the top of this building. Suppose this height is equal to y, and this height is equal to y minus y naught. That means this height is equal to y naught or y zero. The ball starts from the point A and it reaches the maximum height B, then it moves in the downward direction and reaches the ground. And in the first question, you have to answer how high will the ball rise. That means you have to find out this distance. What will be the distance AB? So here the initial velocity of the ball, it is given 20 meter per second. The final velocity equal to 0 meter per second. The acceleration due to gravity, it is negative. That is minus g, so minus 10 meter per second square. And y0 is the height of the building from where the ball is thrown. Height of the building, it is given 25 meter. And using the equation of motion, v square is equal to v0 square plus 2a into y minus y0. And substituting the value of y, final velocity equal to 0, initial velocity 20, 2 into acceleration due to gravity minus 10 into y minus y0, y minus y0 will be equal to 20 meter. So the ball rises to a height of 20 meter from the top of the building, and the total height from the ground, it will be equal to 20. Height of the ball from the ground, it will be equal to 20 plus 25, that will be equal to 45 meter. In the second question, it is given how long will it be before the ball hits the ground. You can solve this problem by two methods. In the first method, you have to calculate the upward motion of the ball from A to B. You have to calculate the upward motion and the downward motion from B to C. So we have to calculate the time taken for the upward motion from A to B and the time taken for the downward motion from B to C. Then you have to add the total time T1 plus T2. And in the second method, you can solve this problem like this. You have to find out the total time from the initial position and final position. Total time taken can also be calculated by noting the initial position and the final position of the ball with respect to the origin chosen. Here we have chosen the origin, that is the ground as the origin. We have chosen the ground as the origin. So let us first calculate the total time using the first method, that is what is the time taken by the ball to going from A to B and then coming back from B to C. Suppose the time taken for the upward motion, that is from A to B, is equal to T1. So using the relation V equal to V0 plus AT, you will get the final velocity at the highest point B equal to 0 and the initial velocity 20 meter per second. Acceleration is equal to minus 10 meter per second square. So T1 will be equal to 2 second. And let the time taken for the downward motion, that is from B to C, is equal to T2. and using the relation y equal to I 0 plus V 0 T 2 plus half a T 2 square. Here the final displacement that is equal to 0 and the initial displacement that is equal to 25 that is 45 centimeter, sorry 45 meter, because from ground to the top of the building it is 25, and from top of the building A to the highest point B it is 20 meter. So y0 is equal to 45 meter, and the final initial velocity at the highest point in the downward motion is equal to 0. So 0 into t2 plus half into minus 10, because a equal to minus g, so minus 10 into t2 square. So if you solve the value of t2 will be equal to 3 second. So the total time taken by the ball before it hits the ground will be equal to t1 plus t2, that is equal to 2 second plus 3 second, that is equal to 5 second. And in the second method we will use the total time taken by the total time taken can also be calculated by noting the initial and final position of the ball with respect to the origin chosen. Here the origin we have taken as the ground. So using the relation y equal to I0 plus V0t plus half a t square, here the initial the final displacement is equal to 0. The initial displacement y0 that is equal to 25 meter. V0 is equal to 20 meter per second and acceleration is equal to minus 10 meter per second square. So if you substitute the value of y equal to 0, y0 is equal to 25, V0 is equal to 20, and a equal to minus 10, this will be a quadratic equation. And if you solve the value of t in this quadratic equation, it will be equal to 5 second. You will get two values, 5 and minus 1. Time can never be negative, so the time value will be equal to 5 second. Since the motion is under constant acceleration, we should not worry about path of the motion. Hence, the second method is a better method to calculate the total time. So in this video we have discussed about one application of the equation of motion, that is the motion in a vertical direction, and in the next video we will discuss about another application of the equation of motion, that is free fall. Thank you.